Hey guys, welcome to this week's live session. We are live every Tuesday at 3. Last week we were not live because we were in Lesotho at Afriski and the connection was terrible up on the mountain. So we couldn't do the live session, but we are back this week. So today we're going to talk a bit about why you should set massive goals and why your goals should not be achievable in the moment, and why your goals should not be normal goals, but it should be massive goals. And by just changing that mindset, that perspective, you'll see that your daily success will increase dramatically. So we're going to talk about that a bit, how your daily success can increase dramatically just by changing the way you set your goals. So we're going to talk about that. But first, a few announcements. Today we're leaving to Springs. For tomorrow we're at Springs Boys High, and then tomorrow afternoon we're at Ediplex High School, and then on Thursday we are at Middelburg for the Know Your Business event. And then next week we're in Pietersburg, at Pietersburg High School, as well as the South African Real Estate IASA event in Pietersburg. So we're traveling a lot. So if you're in any of these areas, make sure that you check our Facebook and Instagram page so that you don't miss out and so that you can join some of these events. Awesome. That was a few announcements. Unicorn Procrastinator, Danica, Ritson and Kuni van Black, thanks for joining in on the live session. If you have any questions, send them through and we will answer them on the live sessions. Any business, entrepreneurial questions and side note hustle questions, send it through and we will answer it live. So let's talk about bigger goals, okay? Why you should set bigger goals. Okay, so as you work towards your goal, you do certain things a certain way, okay? Let's say you're reaching for a goal this high, okay? As you go towards that goal, you're gonna do things a certain way to reach that goal, because that's how your mind works. Your mind sees a goal, and then your mind decides to do certain things to reach that point. Okay, for example, let's say you are driving around a racetrack, right? And if your racing line at the end of the turn is, let's say, 3 meters from the apex, you're gonna aim for that 3 meters, and then you're gonna drive differently when you're getting towards the turn, so that you can take the turn at exactly that point where your goal is at. Let's say you're an archer and your goal is 100 meters in that direction, you're gonna aim a certain height, you're gonna aim a certain angle to reach the target at that point. So because your target is at that specific point, you're gonna change the way you use your bow, the angle your arrow is at, and the distance you pull your arrow back in order to reach that target. Does that make sense, guys? If you're excited about what you're talking about today, send a shop on the live session so I can see I'm on the right spot. Do you understand that? So by changing the direction, by changing the end destination, you change what you do currently with your bow. If we use the example of an archer, getting a lot of shops on the Instagram session this side, and Facebook, thank you so much for joining in today on the live session. So let's talk a bit about that. So you have your target, right? If your target is close, as an archer, your arrow would have a low angle. You wouldn't pick your bow up that much because the target is close, and you wouldn't pull your arrow back that far because the target is close, right? If you pull your arrow back too far, you'll overshoot. Or if you put your angle up too high, you'll overshoot, right? And then you won't hit the target. So intent, your mind will decide to have the bow lower and to pull the arrow, not to pull the arrow so far back. So by choosing a closer goal, you're actually forcing your brain to take a different type of action, not to pull the arrow up too much and not to pull the arrow back too much. But if you choose a goal that's further away, a target that's further away, you are going to pull the arrow back further and you're going to lift the angle of the bow higher. So then you are going to shoot the arrow further because the goal is further. So because of the way the goal is situated, your actions in the current moment changes. Does this make sense, guys? Unicorn Procrastinator, Danica, Kuni, James, Klaas, Theo, Michaela, Wilco, and Natasha, thank you so much for joining in on the live session today. We're talking about setting bigger goals and how that will influence your success every day. So by setting bigger goals, you can change your actions today and increase your success today. So we're talking about an archer, using an archer as an example. And we're talking about putting his target close or far. If he puts his target close, as an archer, you won't pull the arrow back far, too far, and you won't lift his angle too high. Because he wants to hit the close target, right? So he's not going to pull too hard on his arrow. He's going to shoot it lightly so that it just reaches the target in front of him. But if his target were farther away, if his target were 100 meters away, he would have pulled the arrow very much stronger and he would have had his bow at a higher angle to shoot to the 100 meter target, right? And then his arrow would go at a higher speed and at much higher impact. So he will shoot the arrow much faster and further by changing that angle and pulling back further because of the target that's so far away. So what are you getting at, Albert? What are you talking about? By changing the destination, by changing the goal, you are changing the action right now. You are changing the way you pull the arrow back, you are changing the way you are angling and placing the bow, right? Does this make sense? So by choosing your goals correctly, you can change your actions in the moment of now. So if you choose a massive goal, and reach for that goal, you're gonna perform different actions right now to get to that goal. If you choose a small goal right here, you're gonna have different things that you do to reach that small goal. So I want to challenge all of you, whatever your goals is right now, double it, okay? Triple it, triple your goal that you have right now. And you will see that your daily actions will actually change dramatically. Your daily actions will actually change dramatically. If you say that you want 50 grand this month, you want to generate 50 grand a month, you're gonna work a certain amount of hours. You're gonna wake up a certain time in the morning. You're gonna go to sleep a certain time at night. And it's all dependable on what that goal is. But if you say, I want to make 100,000 this month, I want to make 200,000 this month, I promise you, you're gonna wake up at a different time. You're gonna go to sleep at a different time. You're gonna work another amount of hours just because your goal is different. So you create more success in your daily life because your goal is different. On the live session, Theo is asking, so by aiming higher, increase effort and increase the mind and subconsciously increase effort. Yes. So by having a goal that's further, subconsciously, you're physically taking different actions in the moment of now to reach that goal. And therefore, at a daily point, you're more effective and you have different actions, so you're more successful than you would have been if your target was smaller or closer. I hope that makes sense, guys. On the live session now, we have Unicorn Procrastinator, Danica, Ritson, Kuni, James, Klaas, Theo, Michaela, Vilco, Natasha, and Michael Hall, and Cecilia Steenkamp. Thank you so much for joining in on the live session. If you're enjoying the session, send us up so that we know we're on the right track. And if you have any questions, send it through on the live session so that we can answer it live. So we talked about putting your goals further away, having bigger goals, so that it changes the actions that you're currently doing every day. And then you'll find that you'll be more successful every day because subconsciously you're physically acting out differently to reach that bigger goal. Now, the second thing we're going to talk about is choosing goals that you can grow into, all right? If your goals is achievable, if your dreams, if your targets, if your goals is realistic, then that means that you're not putting pressure on yourself, you're not challenging yourself to grow, to attain those goals or to reach those dreams, right? That makes sense, but we don't always think about it this way. You need to choose goals that is not achievable right now, that is not realistic right now, that is not attainable right now. Because in ourselves, we want to grow. We want to become that person that we want to become in our lives. I always use the term awesome Albert, okay? So whenever I'm dreaming about something, whenever I'm looking at a goal, I'm imagining awesome Albert being there, attaining that. So awesome Albert stands on a stage where thousands of people internationally listens to what he says about business and entrepreneurship. That's awesome Albert, right? Now that's my goal, that's my dream, that's where I want to grow to. I want to grow into awesome Albert, right? And that's what you need to do as well. You will never grow that much if you choose attainable and realistic goals. You need to choose unattainable, unrealistic, unimaginable goals so that you can grow into the person that can achieve those goals, that can make that a reality. And by choosing the goals in that way, you will force yourself to grow into that person. You will put pressure on yourself to grow into that person that can actually reach that goal. Because at this moment, you might not be able to reach that goal. You're not skillful enough, you're not fit enough, you're not knowledgeable enough. But by having that unrealistic, that great, huge, massive goal, you force yourself to grow into that person, to gain the knowledge, to gain the skill, to become the person that can actually achieve that goal. That to become the person for which that goal is actually realistic. So there's two things, guys. Choose massive goals, choose big goals because of two things. One, it will change the way you live life and make you way more successful in the moments of now. And secondly, it will put pressure on you and force you to become the person that can achieve those big goals. Guys, I hope you enjoyed the live session today, talking a bit about goals. A lot of people always talk about goals and we feel like it's been talked about too lot and repeated and repeated. But I think this way of thinking around goals is a bit different. It's a bit new and it makes you think better about choosing your goals and what effect it can actually have on your daily life and your daily success. I hope this session was really valuable for you guys. We are live every Tuesday at 3. Make sure you send in your questions or get your questions ready for the Tuesday live session. Any entrepreneurial goals and questions, any business or side hustle questions, send them through. Natasha is saying, yes, it was an awesome live session. Thank you so much for joining in. Unicorn, Procrastinator, Danica Carson, Ritson, Kuni, James, Klaas, Theo, Michaela, Vilko, Natasha, Michael, Cecilia. Thank you so much for joining in, guys. See you again next week, Tuesday at 3 on the live session. And make sure not to miss all of the Middelburg people, our Middelburg Know Your Business event on Thursday.